Obviously, we, as coaches, we all need to know the game. We need to know the X's and O's. But with these young coaches, I think anything you can do to expose them to the other axis. Coaching is a double axis. It's an X-axis and a Y-axis. The X-axis is the X's and O's. We need that. But the Y-axis is what really takes our coaching up several notches. And the Y-axis is the relationship game. And all successful coaches that I work with, that I observe or heard about, really have the relationship game down. And what I mean by that is, it's like a social intelligence, how to connect with your athlete, to do what you can. One of them, the idea of the rule of one, I would use the rule of one with these young coaches, and I would encourage them to give that a shot and to use it in their coaching. It's simple, it's straightforward, it's extremely effective, and it's a lot of fun.
So what is your experience of going through the online or distance connection with the coaches,
yeah,
and then meeting them at the end of the road? What is your experience?
What I do is this. I Skype, but I don't Skype before I meet people. So I go into a coaching situation with a group of coaches, or I go into a program, a team, an athletic team, and I usually spend a minimum of 8 to 10 hours FaceTime between myself and the athletes and the coaches, at least 10 hours. And then I leave, and from that first initial connection, we have established a connection. We've established a relationship. And from that relationship, there's trust and respect, so that when they see me on the screen, I know that guy. We've been with him. That's Jerry. Yeah, okay. So they're all open and receptive. If I did it the other way, yeah, they wouldn't quite get, who's this guy? So there's something special about meeting people face to face and establishing that relationship when we need to initially, and then all that Skype work and everything else that comes after it is easy.
Many times the language is a problem. Things that you talk about, it. Mm-hmm. Once when you hear it and you relate to your past, it's, mm-hmm, you say it's simple. But actually to come to this simplicity, it's a long road. Mm-hmm. What kind of communication tools, what is your advice, how to relate to?
Well, you know, to me, there's no gimmicks. There's no, like, you do this and everything will work out, and no shortcuts. I think there's some language that's universal, that cuts across all barriers, that cuts across all races and relations and religions and everything. And that's the language of listening. And as a coach, as a leader, to listen and to understand, to be positive. We all understand the language of love. And the language of love is not a language of like intergalactic bliss. And you know, love is work made visible. And so what we do, or actually it's, yeah, love is work made visible. So what we do is we want to express that very simply through the modalities that I suggest, which is the idea of listening, understanding, being validating, using the rule of one. Just take one athlete and give them one good positive comment and do that once, and then go on from there. And so we can use these tools that we know about, and what we can do is connect, and it's all about the connection. So we use the tools to connect, and once we're connected, then the sky's the limit. And it's simple, and it's something that's universal. It's a universal language. Everyone wants it, everyone craves it. No matter where you're from, Romania, or whether you're from Australia, or Canada, United States, Mexico, wherever you're from, it's something that people want and crave. And then what we have to do is use the right tools to open the door so that they give us permission to step in so we can do our best work.
It's always the question, how much you do as a leader and just show them, and how much you go to other approach and say, okay, this is solution, you guys are coaches, solve it, and then you debrief after. Any advice how to balance that?
There's just so much we can do. There's just only a certain amount of time. We were given 12 hours with you in this conference. We didn't go a minute over. People have to go. Everyone's busy. There's all kinds of things that have to go on. I've got 175,000 more hours to work with, in my mind. So what I've got to do is, if you give me 5 days, then what I have to do is, it's not about the dissemination of information. If I could walk away knowing after 5 days that everybody in that audience or all those coaches, directors, leaders, have found a way to develop their social intelligence in order to let them be more influential, to create the environments, to give them love, and to self-assess, then my job is done. And if I could do that in 5 days, I'm happy. Like if you gave me 4 more days or 3 more days here, I wouldn't do anything new. In fact, what I do is I go deeper with whatever I did. Whatever we did in these 2.5 days, 3 days, it was more than we needed. We're drowning in all the information. What I want to do is, you give me 5 days, I'm going to do what I did here, and I'm going to spread it out over 5 days and expand and go deeper with the concepts. So we gave you the concepts, we did a certain amount of deepness, I would take it even deeper through experiential ways that I have of conducting groups and group processes. And so it's not more is better. In fact, less is more. And that's one of the outside the box kinds of concepts. Outside the box, oh, less is more. Inside the box, more is better. And so one concept in one of these sessions for 3 days could be enough. One, if you could promise me and guarantee me that you take this message and everybody else will be able to align with it and it'll all be fine. I'm extremely happy with that.